he's had a slight back problem, the chiropractor been up there looked after it, and he had a winner, Howard, and two placements yesterday. Ingalls Driver basically was a 4-6 shot last week to the Yarder in turmoil. Probably has got too big now, drifted too big. It'd be interesting to see how Howard's horses run, you know, until next Tuesday. We've still got, you know, plenty of other horses to run.
Is that Graham Lee you were talking to?
No, it wasn't, no. Yeah. And
Mark.
Hello, Mark. I was at Fontwell yesterday, and you said Howard Johnson has sent in Ralph Harris to look after the horses because all the trouble they've got there. So why are you changing your tune in 24 hours?
Because he had a winner in 2 seconds. And a winner today as well. Thank you, sir. You know, a lot of changes go. 24 hours is a long time in racing. Until yesterday, we didn't have that information. Then, of course, as you say, he had a winner today. I didn't know. He had a winner yesterday in placed horses. You know, it changes, Gal, doesn't it? You know, that horses are sick and then they're not. And I didn't have the information I had from the yard today that they think the horses fit in really well in buzzing.
A long time. We'll come back to you just in a sec, because you can round off now, Kieran.
Yeah, I mean, in answer to your question, on form, I mean, you're way ahead. I mean, he's in terms of ratings, he's run to over 160. He's run to that six times. I mean, he's run to 165, 166. There's not a single horse in this field that's ever broken that 160 ceiling apart from him. That almost makes you think that he could run a little bit below his best and he'd still be good enough. And it's what else is in the race. He's beaten Blazing Bailey pointless every time. He's a real solid horse, but he's priced accordingly as second favourite. I don't think Caswell Bliss would get over the horse box. And he's a flat track bully. They didn't go any sort of pace at Haydock last time. That was no good to him. With Cheetah Lyman, just got no form. I can't believe his third favourite. That hasn't worked out at all, his spy hurdle win last year.
My Way has lost the plot.
My Way seems to have lost the plot. If there's one in there at a big price, and if you don't really fancy taking 7-4 about a horse who could be sick, the one who comes out on ratings, and I think he's about a darker horse as there is on the festival, is a horse called Kazal, coming over from Ireland. He hammered Amatov last time. All his form largely is on heavy ground, but it was good to soft when he beat Amatov last time. He's the sort of horse he improved every time he stepped up in trip. There could be more to come. He probably won't win, but he's 20-1.
Last year, he went novice chasing, didn't work.
He went novice chasing. He's not a chaser at all on looks. He hasn't got the size to go chasing. Take those out of his profile.
And he was impressive last time, wasn't he?
Kazal, isn't he?
I think Kazal's a massive horse, and I think he's a definite chaser as well. He may have come down twice, but he definitely Sunderland's chase winner of the future. But if he ever gets his ground, trainer's absolute. I mean, I've got a lot of time for Owen Griffin, I know him quite well. And, you know, if the ground came up absolutely bottomless, he's got a chance at Cheltenham. But that's what he needed, like, not only the Somme, but like Ypres as well. So, yeah, I mean, I can see what is being said from the point of view. He's the one horse in there who's perhaps got ability.
The thing is, mate, he's 20-1. There's so little else in the race. You're back 20-1 loser, you're back 20-1 loser. But at least there might be improvement there. The others, we know they're not good enough.
For me, this race, you don't need to talk about English Dreamers. The best horse, he will win. I hope they have more and more problems at the yard. I hope there are more and more negatives. The bigger the price, the bigger the bet. And you just say to you, if you're in trouble, come the world hurdle, this is the one you're going to bang out on. You're going to bang out on Blazing Bailey or Caspar Bliss or Wichita Lyman, who'll be dogging it halfway around. No, you won't. You're going to lump on English Dreamer. We're all going to lump on English Dreamer. We all know it. And it's going to be hopefully 6-4, 7-4. If we can get some more bad rumours spread around, let's try and do that. Get it out to 2-1. We're all going to lump on. We know English Dreamer's a banker of the festival. It's going to win.